Hello, I'm Gemma Cairney, a broadcaster, an author, and all sorts. And I presented the awards today, which was awesome. I just think encouragement is really important in a time that is very noisy and overwhelming. You know, if you look at the younger generation and how they're feeling, statistically trickier, mental health is on the rise, academic pressure is very real. And I think if we can somehow just get people excited about the future, if we can encourage people to be creative, and if we can give them a big up as our future generation, then that is nothing but a positive thing.
Who or what was it that inspired you to become a broadcaster?
Oh man, what inspired me? Probably the Spice Girls were my biggest inspiration, and watching like anarchic live TV shows like Live and Kicking or The Big Breakfast, and just seeing so much colour and fun, and just thinking, God, that looks like a fun way to be. And I went to drama school, went to the Brit School, and then I thought to myself, I can't really be anyone but myself. So what should I do? And I thought maybe broadcasting is the one.
As someone who has made it in that very competitive landscape, have you got any advice for young people who would love to follow in your footsteps?
I would never consider myself to have made it, that's for sure. But if anybody wants to sort of go on a wayward path like I and attempt to do something in the public profile, I would just say be yourself. I think it's really hard to emulate others. I think authenticity is really important. And to just be bold and to take risks in a positive sense and say yes to things that might seem really terrifying. Like, I'm constantly scared, but I try things. And then once you've done something that was scary in the first place, it kind of builds your armor for the next time. Oh my goodness, I think it's so important that we look across the country when it comes to encouraging arts and creativity and making young people feel like they can express themselves via the different mediums that are available to us, from theatre to filmmaking to fashion. I would not be doing any of the things that I'm doing without going to a school that was free where I could study performing arts. I mean, it's so fundamentally important to the future. It's hard to even put into words, but I do think that it needs to be everywhere, not just in the big city. I live out of the city now. I moved to the southeast coast of Kent, and I live in Margate, which in some cases is some of the most poorest parts of the UK. And the idea that we're not paying attention to these places is truly heartbreaking.